What's up, traders? Matt from the Trade Brigade here doing a technical analysis on ticker symbol CLSK for CleanSpark Inc. On the left-hand side, we have the daily time frame, and on the right-hand side, the 30-minute intraday time frame. First of all, this will, of course, be a bit of an update. We've talked about it in the past, and the main thing I want to bring up today is the fact that we're starting to break. We finally have a candle close above this resistance trend line right here. So is this the start of a daily reversal? Could be. I do think we need a little bit more confirmation, though, before we're all out bullish on this stock. We certainly have the first step, right? That's low, higher low in here. Now what we want to see, of course, is a new higher high. So arguably it's up and over this area right here. So that is the target. That's the number to beat at 1480. Am I saying that we have to get there tomorrow or the next day or even next week? No, but it would be nice that if we are going to continue higher, maybe we get a higher low pullback to here and then we take that area out to again start and really confirm that this might be the beginnings of a new daily uptrend. So those are longer term thoughts from the daily. Let's shift the attention over to the 30 minute now. Obviously, this is in a much more bullish trend. You can certainly see that we're coming off the lows, forming higher lows and higher highs as we're going. And into the end of the day, the main thing I want to discuss, again, fair bout of volatility this morning. It's really noteworthy, right, that the sellers tried to push this lower. They tried to reject it off of this known area of resistance. It even resisted here, and it just was met with buying. I mean, look at that. We closed fairly strong in relationship to where we were down here at 1240 in the first, you know, hour or so of the day. So I really like that from a relative strength perspective. Let's take out the fibs now and come in from the low of the move, arguably this here, not the entire day's range, but up to here. Obviously, that 38.2 held. We never even came close to it. Let's just double check here coming in from the lows. Obviously, the 38.2 will be lower in this instance. And just seeing if that lines up with structure, not really. Okay, so that's not really going to be of much use. Just noting, though, again, that it was relatively strong, never even coming into either of the 38.2s, no matter where you drew it from here or the true low of the day down here. In terms of levels to watch and what I would really want to see hold, it would be this area right here. Okay, so let me go ahead and throw that on with a price level. There we go. And that's going to be right around 1360, we'll call it for round numbers' sake. It's not so much anymore about this 1331. Let's go ahead and remove that actually just for clarity. And the reason I picked this is, of course, we have prior resistance, but look at what happens here, right? So we get the drive lower, and then we, you know, see the move higher, and that's where the first resistance comes in. That's kind of the breakout point, right? Obviously, from there, we got that next pullback, that next red candle in there. And then once we clear that, that's where we see that sustained uptrend sort of continue into the afternoon. So I'd really love, again, here's your scenarios. This is picture perfect world here. If we were to consolidate here, fine. Look for the breakout higher up and over. Today's kind of highs up in here around this 14 whole dollar. If we take it out, we know what the target is overhead at 1480. After that, you're looking at 1574. If this area does not hold, then the next line in the sand has to be here at 1290. If we were to come down here, look at what we would now have, one and two. This would now be the third touch to that area. So it would start to be a signal that maybe the uptrend on the 30 minute at least is starting to weaken a bit. So that really has to be the area where the next push comes from, and it has to hold going forward. After three touches, levels do start to weaken in my estimation, and we would look for lower after that. So 1290, line in the sand here inside of CLSK. If you enjoyed the video today or learned anything new, let me know in the comments section or by giving the video a thumbs up. Don't forget our main channel is linked in the description. And all of that being said, I wish you a green trading week.